Hi everyone, and welcome to this kind of intermediate video. This is just a small update on the previous video I did on running Windows 98 SE on a modern Apple Mac. While the result of that first video, for which you can find a card here on top if you're interested, is a properly working Windows 98 SE install, I did notice some issues related to graphics while preparing for the second part I plan to do on all of this. That second part will cover some software and games from the Windows 98 era running on this VM. So stay tuned and make sure to subscribe if you don't want to miss that. To explain a bit more about the issue, let me demonstrate. As a virtual video card, I chose the series CLGD 54000. A good reason for that was because that card has drivers included in the standard Windows 98 driver database. While using that card, after completing the setup, changing the resolution and color depth works fine for 800x600, as you can see. But when trying to set the resolution higher, for example 1024x768, you can see that things do not look as expected. But even though 800x600 looked fine at first sight, I did notice strange issues over time. For example, here in Word 97, you can see that this is not looking as it should. The background of the paper should be white, but it's only somewhat correct after typing in the document. Definitely a strange issue. We can see the same thing in Encarta 98, where you can't really ignore the display issues either. It does work, but having it like this doesn't feel right. Another disadvantage, even if a higher resolution like 1024x768 would work fine, is the aspect ratio. At the time, 4x3 was definitely the standard, while today it is 16x9 or 16x10. And as a result, you end up with black borders when running the VM in full screen mode. Enough of time spent covering the issue. Let's go to the solution better. After some digging, I found an older project called VBEMP9X. The outcome of that project is a generic VBE driver for older Windows versions like Windows 98. VBE stands for Visa BIOS Extension. It defines an improved interface that can be used by software to access video cards. In short, with VBE, you can get something better than 640x480 and 16 color without a video card specific driver. The VBEMP project basically backported the generic Windows XP VBE driver to something that works on Windows 95, 98, and so on. Even better is that the driver has good support for emulated video cards like the ones available in QEMU. And on top of that, it adds support for resolutions which have a modern 16x9 or 16x10 ratio. That sounds like a proper improvement, if you ask me. Unfortunately, the download links on the official project page were no longer working, but eventually I managed to find the driver. To make it easy to use it on the VM, I included it on the win98tools.iso, which you can find on my blog and linked in the description as well. Let me show you now how to make use of the driver and change the emulated video card. As mentioned, I included the driver on the win98tools ISO, so let's mount that in our VM. When going to the CD, we can see that the drivers can now be found in this added folder. To change the virtual video card in UTM, we need to shut down the VM first. Then in UTM, we can right-click the VM and click Edit. In the Display tab, we can simply change the emulated video card to Spice QXL and save those changes. Once the VM is booted, we can see that Windows already detected the changed video card. We have the drivers on the virtual CD drive, so let us choose to display a list of drivers, then have disk, and browse for the drivers on the CD. The only option shown and selected is what we need, so let's click OK and continue the installation. And choose to reboot when asked. After the reboot, things do not look as expected. We clearly can't use VBE yet, as you can see by these limited options here. In Device Manager, we can see that the old virtual video card is still there, causing a conflict with the new one. To resolve this, let's remove that Series Logic card and, you might have guessed it, perform another reboot. That looks a lot better. Let's have a proper look at the display properties now and see what we have. The slider for resolution shows a lot more options now. For example, to use the VM full screen on the screen of the MacBook, which has a 16:10 aspect ratio, we can choose 1280x800. And of course, we need a matching wallpaper to make the picture complete. That looks a lot better, right? On an external screen, or for this video, 1280x720 might be a better choice, as that's typically 16:9. As you can see, there is a very wide variety of resolutions, so I'm sure something will match your needs. Now, after going through this, if we check the issues we had before with Word, for example, we can see that these are no longer showing. Same thing for Encarta. This is exactly how it should look. As a bonus, I noticed that game performance and smoothness got quite a lot better as well, definitely a win here. Which brings us to the end of the video. Stay tuned for the real part 2. As mentioned, I will cover some old school software and games running with this method. Make sure to subscribe and enable notifications if you don't want to miss that. And as always, if you liked this video, I'd appreciate a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments if there is a game or application which I should definitely cover in the second part. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you back here soon.